Have you tried to prove your excellence in inter-school quiz competitions? The time is now. Sit back and get ready for the adventure.
Hi all, welcome to another interview preparation strategy series of Geeks for Geeks, and where we discuss about all the preparation required for acing that interview of all the top companies. Our guest for today is Atmadeep Chanda, who is an associate developer at D.E. Shaw and Co. We'll be starting in a while. First, I'll request you all to invite all your friends so that we can start soon. People are live right now. And also you can comment all your questions so that I can address all that at the end of the session. So you can keep all your comments rolling in. Okay, without any other much further ado, I'd like to invite Atmadeep. Hi.
Hi, Shiv.
Atmadeep. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Okay, so we'll be starting the session. First of all, I'd like to ask you about yourself, your brief introduction, and also about your company.
Sure. So my name is Atmadeep. And I graduated this year with a BTech in computer science from Academy of Technology. And currently I'm working as a software developer at D.E. Shaw. And I have completed 2 months over here. So that's about me.
Okay. I think there is some internet issue.
On my part?
Yes, you are lagging a bit. Like you are freezing in between. So can you please check that?
I don't know what might be the problem because here I'm getting a full tower on my network.
Here you go again.
Is it right?
Okay, Atmadeep, I'll remove you and you can join in again. Okay, let's see if that works. Okay, you can go on, Atmadeep.
Yeah, so as I was introducing myself that I graduated this year with a BTech in Computer Science and Engineering from Academy of Technology. And currently I'm working as a software developer at D.E. Shaw India Private Limited. And I have just completed 2 months now. So it's really great working over here. And I
You are stuck again, Atmadeep.
Oh, I really don't know because...
Okay, you can leave this and you can again come to the link. You can click the link again and join in again.
All right, let me try once.
Okay, so we'll be waiting for a while. He's coming back. I don't know what is going on. It is also not lagging behind, but it is freezing in time from time to time. So let's see if this works out. So he's back again.
Is the connectivity right now?
Okay, let's see if this we can get over this time. Okay, so you were talking about?
Yeah, I was talking about myself. I just completed 2 months at Dean Shaw, and it's really great working over here. And so if you want to know about Dean Shaw, so it's basically an investment management firm, and it's basically develops complicated mathematical models to exploit anomalies in the financial market. And so there are different business units of Dean Shaw, and we work among one of them. So that's it about my company.
Okay, so it has been only 2 months since you are here at Dean Shaw. And before this, where were you?
I was doing an internship at Persistent Systems.
Okay.
Yeah.
And did you graduate from your BTech this year only or last year?
2021, this year.
This year.
Yeah.
Okay, can you tell about your college? Where is it and your name of your college?
Sure. So the name of my college is Academy of Technology. It's in Adi Saptagram, basically near Hooghly district. So it's over there. And so that's it.
Okay, so you did your BTech from CS?
Yes, I did my BTech.
Okay. So how are you liking it in the company?
Well, to be honest, the work is pretty good over here. There are many things to learn. And most importantly, the colleagues and seniors are very helpful. So like you get stuck somehow, so there are always people around to help you out. So I must say that is a big advantage.
Okay, so moving further, my next question is, how did you get to know about the opportunity? Was it the campus placement, or did you went for an interview outside your campus?
Well, first of all, it was an off-campus opportunity.
Okay.
And so it was my habit that after a few months or like once in every 2 months, I used to check the campus portals of some product-based companies to see if they were taking applications for new hires. So at that time, I think in January or sorry, not January, six, 3 months back. So at that time, I saw that Dean Shaw was taking applications for new hires. And so I submitted my application over there. And I got shortlisted for the test. So that is how I came to know about the opportunity.
Okay. So first of all, congratulations for your newly placement in the eShop.
Thank you.
Okay, going further about your interview process, how many rounds were there, and can you please briefly describe every round?
Sure. So at first there was an online test, and after that we had 4 interview rounds. So I'm going to describe them chronologically, starting from the online test. So the online test had 2 parts basically. So in the first part, there were 3 coding questions. And in the second part, there were some MCQs based on the CS subject which you studied from first year to fourth year, almost all of them. And the coding questions were of easy medium category. I won't say they were very hard, but easy medium, something like that. Not that they were like, even if you know the answer, sometimes it could be hard to code them within a short period of time. So time management is a real thing, is an important thing while solving those questions. And once you solve all the 3 questions, after that, there are MCQs, like I said, from mostly the important topics like operating systems, OOPs, and database management systems. So we get MCQs from those topics and we have to solve them. And then if you perform well in that test, you get called for an interview. So after giving that test, about I think 1 week or 1.5 weeks later, I got the message that I was shortlisted, and that they would contact me for the first round of the interview. So every round of interview of Dean Shaw is held on HackerDunk, HackerDunk code pair. So now the first round, I was asked to solve 2 coding questions. And one of them was, I don't exactly remember the first one, but the first one was quite a common one. Like, I'm sure people have solved problems like this in Gigs for Gigs or LeetCode or any other coding platform. And the second was a bit uncommon one, but still not a very difficult one. It was related to try data structure, if I remember properly. And if I could remember properly, that interview stressed mainly on optimal time and optimal space complexity. Like, I remember the first question I did solve before. So I solved it using the same method, and the interviewer then asked me to optimize it. And not that it was very difficult, but since I didn't do it before, so I had to think about it a bit, and then I could eventually solve it. So it's better if when students are solving the problem previously, they should always go for the optimal approach, not just stop it once they solve it. So that was the first round. And again, after a week, I got the call that I have cleared the first round, and then I will be contacted for the second round. So the second round was conducted up after a while. I mean, I think there were some issues, so it was conducted after a while. And so the second round, the difficulty of the problems increased a bit compared to the first round. So here, first of all, I was given a low-level design problem. I was not prepared for it because I thought I really didn't revise much about system design and also. But since it was a low-level design problem, so I could give an idea and solve a bit because I was well acquainted with object-oriented programming principles and all, so I could do it. And other than that, there were three coding problems in this round, and I don't exactly remember all of them, but what I do remember is that one of them was a common problem, like again, take a variation of a popular problem in Geeks for Geeks itself. So if someone has solved a lot of problems, he will surely be able to do that. And the other was, I think, a dynamic programming based problem, a medium level problem on arrays. So yeah, so that was one DP problem. Another one was a tree problem based on breadth first search, not a direct application of BFS, that would make it too easy, but a bit complicated one, but not that difficult. So that was the coding questions asked in the second round. But other than that, they also asked me questions about operating systems, mainly the scheduling algorithms. We have different scheduling algorithms in OS. So they asked me questions from there. And yeah, so that was all in the second round.
Okay, may I ask your language of choice?
Well, I choose C++ always.
C++, okay.
Yeah. So that was the end of the second round. And after that, for the third round, I think the third round was taken by the team lead, or I think principal developer, someone. So that was not a coding round. He just wanted to know if I had any technical expertise or something somewhat in Python or projects based on Python. So I said that I used Python previously for DS and also a few basics, but I hadn't done any such projects in Python because I did not do it. And one thing which I made sure was that not lying to my interviewer, not in my resume, not about my skills, because that would be a bad thing if they start grilling on your false accomplishments. So I just told him truly that I did not know much about projects. I did not do much projects on Python. I just knew the basics, because he said that I might be working in Python in the future in my project, which I actually do now. So I told him that at the time I was learning React. So I was doing a small project, not a big one. I just showed him that, and he was asking basic questions like, do you understand the workflow of this project? Do you use comments, proper descriptions and all? Have you ever worked with a team? Like this kind of question. He just wanted to know my technical expertise, not coding efficiency, nothing, any sort of
thing. Right.
So that was the third round, basically. So after the third round was over, I thought that there wouldn't be a fourth round, or maybe the fourth round would be an HR round, something like that. But I got the mail saying that the fourth round was again a coding round. So again a coding round. And so this time, again, the difficulty was much higher and a bit more difficult than the other problems. And this time also, there were
three problems. It was more difficult than the third round?
Sorry?
The difficulty was much higher than the third round?
Well, I wouldn't say the third round was difficult, because third round wasn't really he wasn't really asking me questions. He was just talking to me.
Your second round.
Yeah, second round. Yeah. So obviously it was more difficult than the second round. And so there were two interviews this time. And so the first interviewer asked me a problem on trees and DP. So it was one should have proper knowledge on trees and also dynamic programming, because dynamic programming can be used with many data structures. So that was a bit difficult because that solution wouldn't come to your head at first, even if you did solve a problem, a similar problem. So that took a bit of time, and the interviewers were very patient. So they gave me time, they allowed me to think. So eventually, after solving that, then again they gave another problem on trees itself, and this time it involved binary search and a bit of trees again. So that was also a bit difficult, not the usual medium based problems which you find a bit difficult. So after those two problems, I really don't remember the third one. I just remember two problems, that trees with TP1, another one was trees with binary search, and I can't recall the third one. But so after solving those three problems, and the second interviewer asked me some OOPS concepts, and these are like frequently asked questions on OOPS, like inheritance, abstraction, and all. He asked me to show a few examples of those: polymorphism, inheritance, abstraction, encapsulation using code in Java. He told me to code those things. Then function, overriding, overloading, those things I had to show him properly. And so that was all. So this is how the first four rounds ended.
Okay. So as you said earlier that you were regularly solving questions on HackerRank, right?
When I started out coding, I used to solve on HackerRank, but eventually shifted to Geeks for Geeks, and then LeetCode, Geeks for Geeks, something I can't remember.
Okay, so may I ask, is it important to solve questions on these multiple sites which give you competitive programming, like HackerRank or CodeShift?
Well, yeah, it is important, because though the problems that come in online tests are DSA based, but it's always a story mode approach to the problems. Like, they always write a long story, from there you have to extract the details and then use your sense of algorithms to write the solution. So it's always better to have that kind of practice. Like, if we solve problems on CodeShift or HackerRank, whatever, whichever platform people find comfortable in. So I think it's good because they should be practicing properly with story mode questions, extracting the details and writing solutions. So yeah, it is important, I feel.
Okay. Okay, so moving further, can you describe about your projects that you worked on, and putting those projects, did it make it look different from the rest of the crowd? Like, did you do something different, your frequency of projects and the quality of projects that you did?
Okay, so I did a few projects, but I wouldn't say that it was like something which made it look different from the rest resumes, because I, to be honest, before joining here, I wasn't a very good developer. I didn't do much, spend much time on developing, and this is for the other students, that they shouldn't do this. Okay, they should spend more time on developing, because alongside DSA, they should have the development skills also ready by the time they join the job. But I didn't, because I tried to learn, and I learned few things, but not everything. Like, maybe sometimes I lacked the proper resources, or I spent too much time on DSA, because I began DSA really late in college. So I thought that I should give more importance to it. So, but students now, I think they should properly balance DSA and development together. They should do both. So I did a few projects, and mostly when I took courses from Udemy, projects inspired from there. So I did a few projects like that. And other than that, if you say to make it look different, well, first of all, I did not lie on my resume, not even a bit. Like, I, if there was something, some project like I did not understand something, I did not put it over. So I only put whatever I did myself. And I, that's it. That's all I can do.
Okay. So lastly, can you tell us about your preparation strategies that you used? Anything different for our audience?
Yeah, sure. So so I started DS in my third year of college. And like you can understand that I did not have much time because other than the studies of college, I had to take extra time to practice coding because DS, whatever is taught in college in the syllabus, that is very, very different from the problems asked in interviews and asked in online tests. So the difficulty level is much higher. Also, a lot of thinking capabilities required to solve those questions. So the strategy was that like every day I had a strategy to solve at least two or three problems by myself, like not by seeing solutions, solve entirely by myself. That was a target which I had to achieve daily, whether I came to return from college late or not, whether I had a lot of tasks for the next day or not. That was a target which I had to do because time was not much. Okay, I did not know that Corona would come and like we would get a lot of time back, so we didn't know it from before, so we had to prepare previously. And so that was our thing, that I had to solve so many problems. And after that, when I had a bit of time, so what I started was just participating in contests, taking part in contests. So mainly in LeetCode weekly and bi-weekly contests. At that time, Geeks for Geeks didn't have contests, but now they have also started weekly contests. So
yeah, one contest is starting tomorrow only. Yeah. So this is for you guys. If you want to join in, you can register yourself. It is starting tomorrow and will end by 11th October.
So I believe that participating in timely contests is very, very important because it helps us solve problems in a short time duration, because that is what is more essential during an interview and online test, right? You don't have whole day to solve a problem. You have just 1.5 hours or like 2 hours, something like that. That is the online test. And there are 3 or 2 problems. So you need a lot of practice to solve those. So yeah, that was my strategy: daily solving 2 or 3 problems and participating in contests.
Okay, so guys, solving 2 or 3 problems on your own without any help is very important in developing your skills in DSA. So please keep that in mind. And these were some of the strategies that Atmadeep shared with us. I'll go further now and address some of the questions from the comment section. So we have a question from Shikhar, who asks, what does a company like DE Shaw focuses more on, projects or DS algorithms?
Well, so to be honest, like DS algo is much more, I can't say for sure, but in my case, I think DS algo was more important. Okay, so I can't say for a whole, because maybe some other student or maybe in some different business unit, they might be interested in your projects more. But mainly, I think in my case, as I saw, it was DS and algo more. And they did ask about projects, but they gave more stress on DS algo.
Okay. So Ayusha asks, where did you get the opportunity? We already discussed this, but can you further describe like on which platform did you find about the show?
Okay, so Ayush and to all others, what you can do is that you can visit the website of the show India, and you can check out the jobs portal or the career section. And you can see about all the listings, job listings, which are hiring, which are present for new hires. Okay. They'll be written properly if experience is required or not. And with that, you can find out if you are eligible for that opportunity. And if you think that you have the required skills which are mentioned, you can submit your resume. And if it gets selected, you can expect a test link.
Okay, cool. So I hope, guys, all your questions were answered. Thank you, Atmadi, for this amazing round. And I hope all our audience got a gist of how the interview will be at DE and Shaw, and they will prepare accordingly. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you, Atmadi, once again. It was a pretty good and informative session. I wish you all the best for all your future endeavors.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you, Atmadi. Bye.
Bye.
So this was Atmadeep, and I hope you guys learned a lot today. And as he said, that you need to solve two or three DSA questions every day in order to develop your skills in DS. So that's it for today, guys. This is Shield signing off, and I'll be back again with another webinar. So stay home, stay safe, and get vaccinated, you guys. Thank you. Bye.